welcome to our first virtual Kandu Art Real Film Festival. My name is Mohammed Fersal, Head of Operations, Real Cinema. And it's my great pleasure to introduce you, first of many community film festivals in partnership with Kandu Art Sustainable Development. We felt it was particularly important in what has been a trying times for local, national, and international communities during the current pandemic to continue working with Kandu Art, Nikki Dew, and Wilshire College students on this festival. Be safe, stay well, and enjoy the festival. Now, I'd like to hand over you to the capable hand of Ed Deedigan.
Good evening and welcome to the first Kandu Arts Real Cinema Film Festival, or Kandu Arts Real Cinema Community Film Festival, or Kandu Arts Real Cinema Virtual Community Film Festival. Here amidst and amongst the pandemic, we have decided that we would go ahead anyway, because that's what we do and we'll be flexible. And we've got so many fantastic entries and films that we want to share with you. We thought we got to go anyway. So here we are today. Special thank you to Mohammed Faisal, the operations manager at Real Cinemas, for sharing and partnering in this first project. But we intend together to make this a national project over the next 3 years. So look out for that. But without further ado, I would like to hand you over to the screen and to say thank you all for everyone that's contributed, thank you all for everyone that's watching, and hopefully we'll see you at the end for the webinar. And now, without further ado, sit back and enjoy the show.
Alone. You're always alone. this pain right now. You're always alone. But you are loved. You are loved. So do it. Ask for help. Because you are loved. So do it. Ask for help, because you are loved. I love you.
Fucking freakos!
See that woman's face? Fuck me, she's shit. I don't like that, see? She started crying and stuff. Fucking haunts me. I won't sleep properly now for at least a week.
Disney bother me, Paul. It's all part of your job, eh?
Fuck me, how fast was Dave, though?
Dave?
The security guard, proper fat cunt, but fuck me, he could shift.
Nah, fucking fat Dave shat his fucking fat pants.
What are we doing for food, then? Yeah, I've seen my fair share of Ramirez, but I ain't eating badger shit for no one.
Boys! Fucking talked about this. It's a couple of fucking days. And then we're away to the skies, and it's Viva España all the fucking way, eh? Come on! Ben! First sign of adventure, you want to go crying to your mummy?
I'm fucking starving now, though.
Fucking listen to me, big man. I've had just about enough of you. Look inside your heart. I know who I am, because I fucking know who you are.
Well, if you kept the phone till we found a kit, we wouldn't be in this fucking mess.
Right! I'm away into town then, for we all of it here. You two stay here, mind their bags. Benny, you mind that bag. Alex, you fucking mind that bag as well, pal. Okay?
All right, love, what can I get you?
Got any bags of chimps, please, Hen?
I do wonder what happened to Bob Owners. I used to love Blockbusters, fucking ace.
Dinner is served, you cunts! Where's Alex?
Fuckers, must be having trouble finding a dock leaf or something.
Salmon.
What'd you get?
Chips.
The fuck was that?
Alex! Did he fuck about me?
Fucking dark, innit?
Aye.
Never was good in the dark. As a kid, I used to turn all the lights on in the house. My dad got fucking ballistic.
Aye. He's a top bloke, your dad, Benny. Lot of time for that, cunt.
Jesus Christ! Could have given me a fucking warning or something. Shut myself!
Get the fucking hand!
Fucking two on one's not right.
Come on, you prick!
Here now. Sorry, Sam.
What O is the capital of Canada?
Physical.
This is the O.
Don't know.
That's what we're looking for. It's Ottawa. I'll take an H, please, Bob. H. what H is the surname of the star from the hit TV show Baywatch? Easy, Hasselhoff. I'll take a P, please, Bob. what AP is the name of the bird species with the largest bill on the planet? Pelican? That's incorrect. We were actually the woods.
She wasn't interested.
So what did you say to that?
She just walked away.
She's mental.
I know.
Hey,
both mentals?
Hey, one of the nice friends. Then answer so
softly. Kids, can you go to a room? Just seeing your face lately. I wonder why. Now you're
just a nameless space. Right. Proud, full of people.
I sounded mental.
Jesus!
Stop it! Please! Please! Please!
I need you to do me a favour. Yeah, Jude's not doing really well. Can he come stay with you for a bit? Yeah, cheers, mate. Yeah, no, it's fine. I'm fine.
So how are things at home?
Yeah, everything's good.
I was talking to your dad the other day.
Well, honestly, everything's fine.
But you know that it's okay to ask for help if you need it, right?
Yeah, but I don't need help.
You alright, Tom?
Alright, Ed.
What you been up to?
Same old, different day. You alright, mate?
Yeah, I'm alright, mate. Are you alright?
Yeah, alright.
We're going at the park for a kick round later on if you fancy it.
I would love to, but I'm in here all day.
You're grounded, mate. You're working with me.
Yeah, that's it.
Be good for him to have a run around, eh, Tom, wouldn't it?
Hold on to my drink because the sky keeps falling in. Let's try jump through these lights and win.
Right, listen, we've got a tournament coming up. I was just waiting to hear back from Stanley Park.
Another one?
You guys against these lads from Swindon, if you're up for that.
Yeah.
What's Tommy, you up for it?
Smashed.
No, well, we won't.
It's just about
playing a game, bro.
Playing a game and having something to do. What else are you doing?
That's it.
Who's this?
That's Jude.
He's my nephew, come up from London.
He's come from London?
Yeah, he's going to teach you how to play football, Lucas. I told him. Let's do
tonight. So get out, make it right. We're all so good to go.
So, God, what's going on?
Let's be quick, in and out.
Yeah.
For that queue.
Oh yeah, man, yeah. Hold on a minute.
Sit down. Sit down.
Yeah, man.
Bless.
Yeah.
It's good of you then, boys. I mean, mate, sit down, man. Have a, you know, skin up, innit? That's the loudest, I promise. It's good shit, mate. Sit like,
down, yeah, alright. Having one, then we'll go in.
Yeah, man, chill in. Yeah, fair play, boys, fair play. It's what I've been doing too, mate. And I've been chilling, killing, making a dillin', you know what I mean? It's what it's about, mate, you know what I mean? You gotta make money. Yeah, man. Wait, who is this guy?
Oh, he's my buddy from London.
Oh, London, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Now, I had some mates, they went to London. Went to uni in London. They said it was all right. What's it like?
Yeah, it's all right.
It's all right, is it?
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, man, I'm like my own boss these days. Like, that's like, climb the chain, boys. That's what you need to do. That's what you need to do. Get there, mate. Get P. Keep climbing. Like, keep out here. Keep passing Kingsman's back. Mate.
That's excellent, man. Is this your own stuff or is this part of your course?
No, this is my own stuff.
Wow.
Mix up some of my course works as well. But mainly my own stuff.
Yeah, I love it. You got your own little signature there. You can sort of. Is this your passion then?
What, arts and stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like it. Because from young, that's what I've been doing. That's what I tend to, what's it called? Develop my interest in.
So yeah, no, you're doing brilliantly. It's not, you know, it's a really high level. So, you know, we do sort of lots of arts projects.
Mm-hmm.
And we're definitely interested in getting you involved. You want to do some work experience or maybe do a project down in London with us. Do you have that?
Yeah, I think that would be great.
Yeah? Or do stuff with our young people up here, because let's face it, you don't know where you get your inspiration from. Obviously, you got it from your grandmother.
My grandmother.
Yeah, you got it. But a lot of people haven't got that in their lives, that's what I'm saying. So when you find someone, a young person that's motivated like this, but yeah. You, I mean, I'm talking, you've got a really high standard of not just the art, but it's the whole passion, and you know how much hard work it takes to do something, yeah? Well, it's a good life lesson for other young people. Listen, boys, let me just take this call.
Yeah, no, I was hoping you'd see him. Have you not seen him? Yeah, no, he's not picking up. Now, I'll be finishing a minute. I'll go have a wander around the park. All right, bud. Yeah, then I'll let you know.
Mate, is Ralph going for a piss?
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, it's just through there.
It's fine.
Yeah, it was a good time, man. Like, fuck, you know, I remember.
Oh, it's went fucking live, mate.
Promise, that's like the dang shit. Oh. What, mate? Oh, hey, man.
What's going on?
Oh, I just, you know, have a few zoots and that, bro. Like,
what the fuck's going on?
You know.
Who are these boys? This ain't a youth centre. This is our business.
These boys are customers, innit?
Well, where the fuck's my money?
Well, like, I had to give a few of them it on tick, like, but...
Tick?
Yeah.
Whoa, sit the fuck down. Ain't nobody going anywhere.
Look, I'm sorry.
What do you mean you're fucking sorry?
Well, I mean,
where's the money?
Get it, man. Like, just...
What do you mean you'll get it?
I don't know. They'll
need
get it. They'll get it. I'm sorry.
What do you mean you're fucking sorry?
Well, I mean,
where's the money?
They'll pay.
Where's
man.
The money?
They'll pay.
Sit down.
All right.
Get your phones out. Get me more money now.
I've got the numbers, mate.
Yes, we fucking better get
some money. In the crowd full of people, but I know you. Yes, I know you. And my mind's an empty space, but my thoughts are running wild. Remember, I love you. No matter what you do.
What, mate?
Hello, Dean. How are you doing?
Alright.
Yeah, I'm alright, how are you?
Oh, not the best. What are you doing here?
Just come look for my nephew.
Your nephew? Well, there's a few of them in here, mate.
Tom, what are you doing here? What's going on? Where's Jude?
Oh, Jude? It's Jude here, lads. Is this him?
Oh, this is him, alright.
Yeah?
Yeah, this is Jude.
Is this your nephew, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow, he owes me a bit of money, mate.
Does
he? They all do, in fact.
Oh, do they?
Yeah, they do, yeah. They've got something and they haven't paid.
Well, listen, do me a favour here for old time's sake. Let me take that.
I don't know who's going to pay the debt.
Come on, Dean.
I don't know, mate. I don't care how old the fuck they are. They're old enough to get it.
Do me a favour for old time's sake, mate.
Because I know you are. It's only happening this time. If it happens again, they're dead.
Understand.
Get out.
Come on, you lot.
All of you now. Out. If it weren't for him, you'd all be goners.
Yeah.
Go on, fuck off.
Hey, I knew you were here.
Look after him.
I appreciate it.
Well, you're going to have to work a lot harder now to pay off all your debts, aren't you?
Popular lady, right, aren't you? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
What's going on?
What? What's used a bit of Stevie for our birthday shit? Oh.
Husband passed away, man.
Did he?
Oh. Fuck, that's bad.
Finished.
Oh,
I am absolutely knackered. I was up at daft o'clock this morning.
Well, it's like your mother says, you're not gone to bed at night and you'll not get up in the morning.
Don't do that, love. We've talked about it.
Mm, why, it's good.
She's making it sound like she's just climbed over the wall at Broadmoor.
I know.
I couldn't agree more with you, son.
Oh, it's a builder.
Hi, Yaz.
Anything for 69?
Yes, there is. Yes?
How do you get that?
No.
So she stood there, right, in her nightie, growling at us like a fucking leopard. Right? She just offers us the lot.
It's a uniform, man. Lass has gone mental for
it. Ah, that's shill bottle lasses. That's what that is.
Oh, well, mother was from shill bottle, you cheeky twat.
Did you? No offence, Shep, mate.
Oh, fuck off, Shep, man. His mother's from Barrowsdale.
Ah, you know, kid.
Hey, yeah. Saturday night, me and Jums entered the talent competition, doing a bit of comedy.
Ah, no.
Down.
No, I thought it wasn't definite, David. We said, like...
It is definite, because I've paid the entrance fee. No,
I thought you had to be funny to do comedy.
Oh, brilliant.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Word, lads.
No chance, Kenny. We've got a job on in Shillbottle. We'll have to see you tomorrow.
See you later, Dave.
No, not you, you dick. You're coming with me. You've been shot a bit.
Hey, lad, one word from me and the deer's alike. Jump, when you shall like.
Ah, oh, no, Ken, I've got to go to the bend, son.
It's a serious one.
Me and Alice have set a date.
Have you? Oh, congratulations, Kenny, that's brilliant, man.
I've got a big question to ask you, like. Right. I mean,
I was thinking.
Yes,
and
Kenny.
And she, you know, obviously mm-hmm. she said to me to ask. But
right.
To you,
come on,
it's up to yourself, son. Mm-hmm. I didn't want you to, you know, feel obliged or anything.
Kenny, what are you asking us, man?
Will you be my best man?
Kenny Corsewood, mate. I'll be honoured. Thanks a lot, man.
I'm going steady on the stag, like, near Strippers League.
Oh, no, near bother, near Monkey Blast, none of that. Listen, I'm off. I'll see you later, right?
Chip.
I've had Mr. Fraser on the phone from London Framley.
Shit, Ken. Hey, lad.
You were in late last night.
Aye, rehearsing.
So you're doing it then?
Why? Do you not want us to do it, like?
No, I don't.
Oh, thanks a lot, love, for the support of that.
You've been round there 3 times this week.
Well, no, we're walking up an act, Jackie. We're rehearsing, man. We're a canny little earner, like the young ones said.
The young ones.
You know, the gigs is like Amble, Ashington, Morpeth, Cramlington, Bedlington.
We just miss you, is all.
Durham, Berwick, Hexham even. You want to Scotland in that Glasgow all that. Here comes trouble.
What's for tea?
Oh, you're starting on us, like, hey, I'm old and fast, but you're young and dangerous. Come on, son. No, listen, son, right? When you throw the punch, slap when you're near on my face, right?
Ian, that was brilliant. Liam, you're dead coordinated.
Well, his old father springs back into the ring, and they're ready. The crowd are gone mental, and then...
Yeah. I've left the money on the mantelpiece for Chucky Edgar.
Oh, Hobbs.
Are you fine?
Oh, yes, Barry.
I don't know what that means.
Bob, you in?
Fuck. Hey, no, are you... What's the two bodies just came in there? You're not meant to clean them from the fucking inside.
Valerie, where are you?
Still hungry.
That makes a change. Hey, Liam. Fine. I hope you starve. I don't. I love you so much. I'm gonna break your mother's heart.
Do you know, you're always on my mind.
Well, that's very touching, Chef. But I'm a little bit fucking busy.
What about Suspicious Minds?
Yeah.
You don't know Suspicious Minds?
Yeah.
The cattle trap. But I can't walk out. Because I love you too much, baby.
As well as the magic,
yeah.
I'm going to do an impression.
Oh, not a good idea at all. Leave the impressions, just do what we rehearsed.
No, you didn't get it, do you? What I'm going to do is the magic, and then I'm going to do an impression. Right?
Fucking leave the impressions, do the magic!
No.
You're not fucking right!
Ah, fuck you, I'll still have a way.
Just see an impression.
How is it fine? We're Dean, there are impressions, they cannot get on the impressions after them, man.
Right, we'll put a dove out yours and do some magic.
How? I'm fucking nervous. Devon snap at us, man.
Right, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to snap.
Yeah, we got to ask all the other day.
Who?
Me dad. All right. He was standing at me back gate. He held up 3 fingers.
Did he?
You're right, sarcastic bastard, you.
Sweetheart, your dad's been dead since 1979.
Doesn't mean he can't visit, does it? He holds up 3 fingers and I've got number 3 on my Domino's card in the club. Can you believe that?
Oh, my God, you have not. Someone crack open the champagne.
Listen, do you want a little nibble whiskey, like?
What? No.
Why not?
You can't have one either.
Why?
Because if you have one now, you've got to have one before every show.
Oh, God.
Do you know what I mean? It's not good.
You're all nervous, like.
Yeah. I'm going to go for a tap.
Of course.
Guys, to see you, baby. No!
Oh, for fuck's sake, please.
Are you Dave the window cleaner?
Aye, why?
You haven't seen a mouse.
It's an occupational hazard, mate.
Still a good fucking clever one, mate, son.
Calm down, I'll fucking kill you.
What?
Oh. Who's he?
He's arse, what is that? I'm too alone. Tina, you look knackered, mate.
Fuck off. Babies aren't over the lions.
Easy, man, she's just saying.
Yeah, but...
I'm sorry, I'm just really nervous.
Oh, God, me too. Aww. Absolutely shitting myself.
That's so cunning.
Hey, hiya lasses.
You all right?
Yeah,
canny.
Yeah.
We're all canny. Yeah. Do you know Dave Brown's Mrs. Tina?
Lovely to meet you, doll. Hey, aren't you, Barry? I love your hair.
Thank you.
Don't do that. Well, I better get to the bar. My liver thinks my throat's been cut.
Who do you think she is?
She's a fucking dick.
Right. Howdy, man, settle down. I can fucking see you. Right, a couple of local lads for you, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a chance, at absolutely no expense, get Gaughan and Bennett.
Cleaning your bloody windows.
Ah, you better not be shit.
Yeah, I don't
know, so. I'm Alan Gaughan.
And I'm Dave Bennett, and together
we are
Gaughan and Bennett.
Fuck off, Frankie.
There is something quite beguiling about you. And all the dreams I had, you made them true. Now there's nothing really left except the heartbeat in my chest and my never-ending love affair with you. Your rivers and hills are mighty as they flow down to the sea. From your castle walls to your North Sea shores, a land of majesty. There's something quite enchanting about you. There is magic in everything you do. Now there's nothing.
I thought about it all till everything became so weighted. You're draining all my love. You drained a boundless drop from that boundless ocean. And it seems now she falls. Even now she just don't know you at all. I was waiting on the chance. And the hope she might just drift on by like a dream that just erodes away when we open our eyes. When we open our eyes. And it seems that she falls. Even now she just don't know you at all. By the cracks in my palms, by the darkest pastures behind your smile, we made a dream. I rode away before our eyes, before our eyes. I was waiting on the chance. I'm a hope she might just.
This is nice, Dickie. Hey, you doing all right for yourself? Lovely job.
Oi! To what do I owe this displeasure?
Steve, tell you what, why don't you go and have a look around outside?
Don't want to go outside, it's freaky.
Look, mate, I told you, it's just nature, nothing to be scared of. Isn't that right, Dick?
Do what your dad says. What's your game?
Life and death, as usual, Dick.
What's that supposed to mean?
I've got cancer, Dickie. I've got 6 months to live. No one else to tend to. Boy needs the home. I thought, oh, I know. What about Dickie? He always sorts things. Good old Dickie.
I'm
delighted?
Shocked.
But not sad, I noticed, Dick. Anyway, thought to myself, well, Dickie and Jane couldn't have kids. Ties itself up rather nicely, don't you think, mate?
It's Jill. And Jill is going to have a lot to say about this.
She always did, Dick. That's why we haven't seen you for 10 years, isn't it?
Look, I'm making a cup of Earl Grey. Would you like one?
Earl Grey?
Richard? Who's that lawyer? Oh, it's you.
Good to see you too, Jane.
It's Jill.
That lovely boy outside, yeah? It's your nephew. Not that you recognise him, of course.
Richard, can we have a word, please?
Help yourself to milk. Well, a slice of lemon's better for you.
What's going on, Richard? Why are they here? Is he in trouble again?
He is in trouble, but this time it's terminal.
Terminal?
Darling, he's got cancer. He's only got 6 months to live. He knows about us and the fact we can't have children. So he thought he would leave us his son as our inheritance.
When's he going?
I promise you, as soon as possible.
On the street and they're fighting for what? I just don't know.
And where are you going in such a rush?
I'm going out.
Oh, you knew your brother was coming home today.
Well, yeah, but I have work to do.
Oh, you're not going to get into trouble, are you?
Well, I have a good role model.
Oh, shit, Nathan's paid his dues.
Yeah, if it wasn't for Nathan's situation, I'd be in college.
Don't go spoiling it.
Want me to work today?
Well, come in, so this is the door. You can enter and exit the property using this. It's wooden, fits into this hole here, which is the door frame, as it were. So this is a hall. This is a section of the house adjoining different bits of the house, if you see what I mean. This is a kitchen in here. Don't come in. It's got everything fully functional. There's a cooker. If you wanted to cook something, I don't know what evening meal you have planned. Maybe you have a chicken or something you could put in there, or maybe a vegetarian quiche, or another option, moussaka, something like that, perhaps. So we're coming through here now. So this is a wall there. This is made of a different substance, not wood. This is more concrete, stone, as it were. This is a small model boat. It's not a real boat, so don't try and take that out because it's very small. For a start, you wouldn't fit in it, and if you did and you went out in it, it's probably not got a strong enough rudder to withstand the current, because we're on quite a strong current here. I mean, if you went to, Falmouth, for instance, and you took it on the River Fal, where the current isn't as strong, you probably have a better chance. But on the sea, in that, you wouldn't last 5 seconds, love. So then we go up. These are stairs. These are used to join, again, different parts of the house. Similar to a hallway, but they're vertical. Well, they're not exactly vertical. There's a slant and it's sort of an angle. So this is another room. This is a bedroom here. Now this is a mattress. That's the sort of piece of a bed that your body immediately comes into contact with. Normally there's a base and springs and so forth. The gentleman who rented the house before you was a heroin addict, unfortunately. He died on that mattress. So we can leave that in if you want to sleep on that, that's fine. Or you can buy another one, it's up to you. And if you want another one, I can arrange for this to be taken away.
another one brought in, and that'll be added onto the bill. So these are the windows. This is made out of glass. Now, glass is a substance that's see-through, but don't attempt to walk through it or position a body part through it, because even though it's essentially compacted sand, it can be very sharp. Well, you are right there? There's some sandpaper there. You yes. Be careful of that. That's quite expensive. Yeah, that I don't know if I can use that again now. I might have to. I'll stick that on the bill as well. Yeah, I'm afraid so. Sorry about that. So this is a stereo system there. Both, you can listen to music. I don't know what sort of music like. There's all sorts of different ones. There's spirituals, that sort of gospel music associated with the, you know, south of America. That's a nice type of music. There's merengue, that's a dance. There's a sort of steps to go with that. Cha-cha-cha, similar sort of thing. There are different types of music. The tango as well has its own music. That creaking sound is a ghost. The house is fully haunted, which is
a bonus.
Yeah, it's a good selling point. A lot of tourists enjoy that. A lot of holiday makers, when they come down, they say, "Oh, is it haunted, Freddie?" And I say, "Yes, yes, it is," by quite a virulent and unpleasant poltergeist. Actually, sometimes things get thrown around, and some people have left screaming. Anyway, so now out there, you can see the sea. Now the sea is essentially a huge expanse of water. The earth is covered in water. It's in fact 70% land mass is water, and that's water there. It's similar to the water you get in a tap, you know, same sort of thing, except that's seawater, so it's very salty, so I wouldn't advise you to drink it or bathe in it if you have any open wounds, you know, if you have a cut, or if you have, if you're an amputee, for instance, a recent amputee. Chandelier is an interesting piece. That was, purportedly from the Winter Palace in Moscow during the revolution in 1917. Apparently the Bolsheviks smashed up the Winter Palace, but this was saved. I bought it off a man in Redruth, Carbuccio. It was £3, that.
Don't worry, darling. We can paint it up or something.
So this down here, now this is being converted at the moment. It's a kind of utility room / workshop. So I don't know if you have any hobbies, you know, masonry or similar, you could use this room to pursue that?
No, I don't. It's fine, thank you. We'll take it. What do you reckon? Yeah.
Great, good stuff, madam. So that's £600 a week cash, please.
And would it be okay if I do a little bit of decorating?
That's absolutely fine. Yeah, do you like get painting, you can decorate. The only thing I'd say is when you move out, I want it restored back to exactly how it is now. So that'll probably cost you a little bit more, but that's fine. We can work something out, put that on the bill with the sandpaper and the new mattress. So it's great. Right, that's £600 there, is it?
Yeah.
Right, do you mind if I check that?
No, you won't.
Do you live here?
No, just visiting.
Us too. How long are you here for?
Not long, I wouldn't think.
Oh, that's a shame. I think I'm here for the whole summer. Who are you visiting?
My uncle.
Maybe we can hang out while we're here.
Okay. Got nothing better to do.
What's your name?
Olivia.
My name's Stephen.
Oh, hi, darling. Who's this?
This is Stephen. He's staying next door. He's on holiday too.
Oh, that's really great.
Yeah, we're going to go exploring.
Okay, well, actually, if you hang on a second, I'm going to go down to town. I need to get some supplies, some paint and stuff, so I can drop you off.
Okay, I just got to ask my dad, though.
Okay, fine. I just got to grab my bag.
Here, we'll wait for you by the car.
Okay.
Thank you.
hell are you doing?
Oh, I think there's some Perthy wool washing up liquid in the mug.
Bergamot.
For some type.
Bergamot. It's in the tea, you pleb. Listen, you're only here a couple of days. I'm going to take you downtown, show you the sights.
Oh, you mean the pub?
Yeah, well, a couple of days, I promise, that's all I need. Yeah, but what about Stevie?
I'll look after Stephen.
Appreciate it, Jane, thank you.
It's Jill.
Yeah, Jill.
Oh, wait, Mum, please can I have some money for some food?
Yeah, sure. Don't spend it all at once.
Yeah, okay, I won't.
Don't forget to let me know what you're doing.
Okay, see you in a bit.
Have fun.
No, you ask her.
No, you ask her. Excuse me. Do you know where your nearest McDonald's is?
McDonald's? Near here?
Yeah.
Well, the nearest one's like 30 miles away. Your best bet's probably the Chippy or my mum's pub. She does the best pasties for miles.
Sounds good. Where's that?
If you wait 5 minutes, I'll take you there myself.
Okay.
Alright, girls, coming down the beach later?
Could do. What time?
About 6-ish. Oh. Bring some friends.
Okay.
Alright, see you later.
Bye.
Morning, Sarah Lee.
Hi, Rick. Do you want your usual?
Yes, please, darling.
This handsome
day. Ooh, that's sweet.
This bad penny's my brother.
Kept him hidden away, and what would you like?
I'll have a pint of his usual, please, don't you?
So, a pint of dry white wine, then.
Dear. No, you're all right. I'll just have a double vodka and coke, please, darling. Have one for yourself.
Oh, I will.
Rick's paying.
Rick. You leave it out. I've reinvented myself down here. You got it?
Reinvented yourself? Seems to me, mate, that you've torn up the blueprint.
Rick. Dickie. Dick.
That was 50 pounds, please.
Well, you're having a good day today.
Is that right, I suppose?
Ask for a seat, but I don't suppose I can get one of those.
Again. I guess you can push to take this.
love, I'm really busy. I haven't got anything right now. I will have a look, okay?
Oh, hi, darling.
Hi.
Your friend?
Hi. Alright?
Yeah.
I'll bring you past
the you don't want to move me around with those costals.
They're just on holiday.
Why has she got paid then? Hey, is people like her stop people like us being able to afford our home? She's got a second home there.
We're just going to go to a party.
Yeah. Like, well, you do what you want. We'll see who's right at the end of the season.
Oh, Mum, please, it's just a party.
Yeah, but darling, I don't know any of the people. I don't know where it is.
It's on the beach and there's just loads of people.
What time is it going to finish?
I don't know. What time can you collect me?
9, at the latest.
9? Oh, please, 10.
10?
Please.
I'll be asleep by 10.
No, please.
Okay. All right.
Thank you. Love you, Mummy.
All right. Bye, darling. Have fun.
No, that's all right. I got a taxi.
Oh, did you?
It's not for me, is it?
Yeah.
I can see you've got no better in art since I've been away. What's Jason?
He's gone out.
He knew I was coming home today.
He said he had some work to do.
What sort of work?
Why don't you just cut the cake?
No. What sort of work?
All right, if you're your boss.
Joking, aren't you? How long's this been going on for?
Since he was 15, he barged in here with a couple of his mates and said he had to do some work to help pay off your debts.
I'm going to kill him.
Well, and then you'll be back to square one and might not get out next time. Come on.
My debts?
No, come on, let's just cut the cake.
Let's cut the cake.
Euchre, mate, do you play euchre? No? It's a card game popularised, I suppose, essentially by the corner. So I think it's French in origin, hence the spelling and the name. Fancy a game?
Yeah, why not?
It's fairly complicated, we can play 21 if you like.
Is it like 21?
No, nothing like 21 at all, that's what I'm thinking. This is 21's probably an easier game for you, but we'd have to play local rules, you see what I mean?
Well, no, you know what I'm saying, we're in Rome, do his rules.
Yeah. Alright, we'll play 21, yeah, but we'll play Truro rules, which is similar to Camborne, but there's a couple of differences. I'll go through it with you as you're playing, yeah?
Yeah. So, do you... play for money? What do you do?
Yeah, well, what'd you say, like, start 50s? 50 a hand?
Or 50 pence? Oh, go on, what, 50 notes?
Start.
So,
Camborne rules, you start with 5 cards. Start with 3.
Yeah.
Because you're playing Truro rules, you start with 7. Right?
So, you said this is like 21s, yeah?
Yeah, this is 21, essentially the same game as 21, yeah, but you start with 7, yeah.
And I'm picking these up?
Yeah, and a joker, when it's my joker, it can be any number. So, for instance, 21. See how it works? That's 10, that's 7, that's 4.
Alright, so I've got... Okay, so I've got
what you
eight.
Got, mate?
I've got jokers.
Oh, right, no, well, you're busting, mate, because it doesn't work that way on your hand, you see what I mean? It can only be 21 on mine.
You've only got 3, why is it?
Yeah, exactly, that's the rules. It'll swap around later on. When you're dealing, then you'll get a say.
Right, so when do I get to deal?
Well, Camborne rules, you wouldn't get to deal today. It would probably be, like, a week Wednesday you'd get a go dealing.
Play it.
All right.
Play this for money.
We'll play Red Roof rules, right? Which is similar, but just very slightly different. You know any cards, mate? Cheers, bud. So that's 50 owe me, but we'll just play on, yeah?
Well, one sec, we ain't started yet. You would just show me how to play.
No, that's the first hand, mate. That is the rules, because it's Nuki rules, isn't it? Do you know what I mean? so just slightly different. So we'll play Red Roof Rules now. So basically I get one card, you get...
Listen, old, what's the name at the bar, said you're the man in the know, is that right?
Well, yeah, it depends what you want to know, doesn't it?
Well, you sort things.
Yeah, I can help you out, yeah.
What sort of things can you sort there? Can you sort?
I'm saying I can help you out, mate, so yeah, you let me know what you need.
Yeah, but this...
21 now. Well, because that now, because we're playing Nuki rules, that's now a 9, you see?
Is that because you've got reds?
Yeah, well, it sort of works like that, but it's slightly more complicated than that. It's to do with, it's not just the colour of the card, it's to do with the suit and also the make of cards.
Well, wait, I've got 1, 2, 3,
yeah.
4, 5, 6, 7,
yeah,
8, 9.
Yeah, you're well bust there, mate. That's a lot more.
Well, obviously
than
I'm bust. I've almost got 21 cards.
Well, that's what we're playing. Tell you what, we'll start again, alright?
We're still playing for money, though, right?
Yeah, no, that's another 50, mate, so that's 100. So we'll do Penzance rules now because it's a little bit easier
look,
for you.
I'll tell you what, 1 second.
Yeah.
Paul, give me a favour here.
Yeah.
Do me a favour.
Yeah.
I might need a favour.
Oh, right. What sort of favour do you need then?
Well, if you can sort anything, when you say anything, what do you mean by anything?
Well, it depends what you want, doesn't it? What sort of thing are you looking for, mate?
Give me a number and I'll give you a little text, yeah?
All right.
I'll give you a phone call later on.
Okay.
All right. One second. First things first. Let's just get the 50 quid sorted.
Well, I think it's 100 now, right? Tell you what, you just give us 50 for now, you can give us 50 later on when we sort the other thing,
yeah? Oh, right, yeah, sweet, we'll have it to do you.
Hand on many 50s, dear.
Well, you gotta be careful, see, a lot of counterfeit about, you know, you gotta check it's kosher, as our Israeli friends were saying. Right, so, Penzance rules.
I tell you what, listen.
Yeah.
Just give me a number.
Uh huh.
I'll give you a shout later on, maybe we can resume the game, yeah?
Oh, yeah, it's 0-0-0, 1-0-0-0-0-0.
Better write that down.
Oh. 0-0-0-0. 1-0-0-0-0-0-0-0-0. There you go. Oh, you bust again now, mate. That's another 50.
Evening, gents. What can I get you?
Two rooms, booked in the names of Peters and Lee. Something funny.
Just Peters and Lee? Welcome home. Welcome home.
That's Matthew Peters and Brandon Lee.
It gets worse. Bartholomew slept tonight.
My dad was a big Bruce Lee fan. Have you got a problem with that?
No, I was a big fan myself. Cursed that family were.
Cursed the rooms.
We've only got one. We weren't sure what the relationship was.
Are you trying to say we're gay?
No. It's just that we weren't sure what the relationship was, so to speak, and sometimes people don't mind sharing.
A twin then?
No, a double.
You're on the floor.
What happened last time? What happened?
Oh, this girl got like so drunk because she was sick, all in the sea.
You've been serious.
So
who's going tonight then?
I think it's just the usual.
Yeah, you'll meet me tonight.
Alright.
Weirdos.
You're on the floor.
No, you're on the floor.
Rock, paper, scissors. Rock, paper, scissors.
Floor. Rock, paper, scissors.
I'm done with this. You can use the bathroom. That's fine.
Who's the daddy? Is he two? What two? This fucking two.
Did you call me?
No, just clean my teeth.
No, sorry.
Overpowering. Darkness dims, sparking up a spliff. I've realised a few little hints, sights and signs that I've missed. Insist me to fix up a bit. Think, resist them, rinse in my crib. They're treating me like shit. Revised and compulsive lies, disguised by repulsive. Low life's inflicting negative impulses inside. Dark cloud disguised in my twisted mind. It signals bumpy roller coaster rides. Trying to divide, guard, split away hard. Elevate high, deny the fake aside. I'm Jekyll and Hyde, emotional times too kind. But dying to commit crime, so that explains why I get high. Freezing cold shivers down my spine. Intertwines my mind state to revise to fight. Cause I despise people's spite. Should've known this road wouldn't have felt like hope. Incidentally, started to show a lost hope. Surrounded by a wet, struggling to cope. Stumbled, tumbled straight off the wagon. Lost in the fiery hole. Lost souls have lost hold. Grown unexpected passions. Lost for control. Evolves addictions to drag and smoke. He's inhaling toxic vapors. Evaporating his wages. Metal pipes contaminating in stages as the street life goes through
phases. Yo, you want to drag on this, mate? That shit's pain, man. You tried that shit before?
Yeah, loads of times.
Why are you coughing then?
It's the sea air, it's bad for my asthma.
Right, mate. What the fuck you do that for?
I don't know.
Fuck's sake.
She's got something. She would like to say. She's got troubles. Gray clouds block her.
Trust those dodgy pub toilets.
How'd you get in here?
That back window's an estate, mate. That's a bit loose. You watch that, anyone could get in.
You broke into my house to have a shit?
Listen, mate, it's a bit extreme, isn't it? I broke in, I had a shit. I did it in the toilet, I didn't do it in the fucking oven.
Oh, you flushed it?
No, I left it for your missus to find. Of course I flushed it. What'd you take me for?
That's the point. I'd rather not take you at all. I'd rather leave you and your shit in my past. I didn't ask you here. Shit always happens when you're around.
All right, mate. Enough of your shit analogies. If you insist, yeah, you're right. My life's been a bit shit. No amount of flushing's going to get rid of it. But the way I see it, Dickie, it's a win-win situation, isn't it? You get a ready-made family without the shit bits. Win-win.
Use this in future. It's what normal people do.
You'd know all about normal, wouldn't you, Dick? Twat.
Evening. So, what business have you two got down here, or is it pleasure?
Actually, it's business. We're private detectives. We've been following this guy down this way, Andy Nostrum. Have you seen him?
Never seen him.
Yeah, and that fucking time, what was her name, Lindsay? Remember she had those really drippy mates and you really pissed them off. They're playing that track. What was the track? Play about 20.
Johnny and Mary.
Johnny and...
Johnny's always running around, trying to find...
Guys,
certainty.
Keep the noise down. Some of us have got work to do.
Sorry, love.
Yeah, anyway.
Do you want some cheese and crackers?
Yeah, fuck it out. What about that French bird? What was that French bird's name?
Mary Paul.
Mary Paul. Fuck me. What do you call her?
Breton Breaker, mate.
Okay, now. She was beautiful, but by God, she used to get pissed off of you. Remember that time you opened those bottles of beer on the television?
Yeah, I broke the telly, do you remember?
I fucking remember it. Oh, my Lord. She wasn't impressed, was she? Nice girl, though.
She had her moments. There's the cheese.
That's nice, mate. What sort of cheese is that?
It's Taleggio.
And what's that one, is that?
That's an Italian soft cheese.
An Italian soft cheese? That's lovely. Are you sure you relate to me? I don't know. I guess I needed you in spite of that. Hey, anything normal now can get me down. Hey, anything normal now can throw me out. Hey, anything normal. Don't you miss it?
I was an accountant.
Oh yeah, bruv. You were an accountant, yeah, sure thing. Well, then I was a social worker. Pope was a Buddhist. Mahatma Gandhi is a fucking dictator.
I liked to balance the books.
Yeah. How'd you like to get even on that?
She's got something. She would like to do. She would like to spend her whole life with you.
Hello?
Yo, Joe, what's the hurry, man? You look shook.
Yes, I've bumped into you.
Oh, listen, Mum's told me what's going on, and I'm going to sort it out.
Mum's got a big mouth. I can sort my own shit out. You can't sort anything out. Look at you. You ended up fucked up in prison. See, even hits like a bitch.
and that fucking, what was it, 5 hours easily, wandering around with those fucking animals.
Do you remember how annoyed they were when we got back?
Oh yeah, but fuck them, but when we were starving, we couldn't find anywhere.
There was nowhere, not a single shop open to get a bit of bacon.
You promised me. Well, yeah, fuck it, we'll have it. So, that was funny. Oh no, Stevie. You alright, Beth? What? Oh, fucking hell, you're joking. Where are you? Alright, mate. Well, she's bringing you back. Ah, oh, alright, Beth, alright. Yeah, yeah, no, I'll go and tell her. I'll go and tell her. Alright, mate. Yeah, good boy. Alright. Fuck's sake. You know that woman next door? Little girl's got fucking taken off to hospital. She got nearly half drowned, apparently.
No.
Yeah. Better go and fucking tell her. Jesus Christ. They fucking don't tell her what's in it. She'll fucking blame me.
No worries.
Stays constant in the sky. The earth turns your head to face the night. The moon reflects the constant sun to remind you of the dawn to come.
Morning, love.
Your brother was up and gone early this morning. He's a liability.
He's my brother.
Never mentioned him once in the last 10 years, let alone that poor boy.
He'll be gone soon. And all we'll have is that poor boy.
Hello, then. What time
are
you
going to? Late.
Did you catch up with your friends?
I didn't catch up with anyone.
Do you want a coffee?
Maybe later. Where's Jason?
Didn't come home. I think he might have stayed at Jay's.
Has he avoided me, I say?
Why'd you say that?
Every time I seem to be here, he's not.
He's a teenager. You were the same. Didn't see you from 15 to 20.
And then only at visiting hours.
That's in the past. First, I'll look into the future.
Mum.
Yep.
When you see Jason, tell him I'll sort it.
Why? Where are you going? What are you going to do?
Just tell him I'll sort it. Steve.
Where's my dad?
He's gone.
He's always gone.
We've got some nice croissants for breakfast. They're a really nice French pastry.
French pastry? Are you sure you're related to my dad?
Well, what would you like?
Cocoa Pops.
Cocoa Pops? Oh, alright, I'll have to go down the shops because Jill's gone to work. You have a shower, it's just through there. I'll be about 10 minutes, okay?
Come in, mate. Make yourself at home. I'll sit down.
It's all right, isn't it? You did all right for yourself?
Yeah. I don't sit there, mate. That's my seat. That's the sofa. Yours is that chair there. That's allocated for customers, that one.
Well, you have a lot of customers, do you?
Yeah. That's a customer chair. That's allocated for you, you see.
What, this is your office, is it, or something?
Something like that, yeah. Or I conduct business, yeah.
What, so it's all like, what, a formal thing, is it? You've got the advertising.
Very formal. I keep things, you know, above board.
What, and you pay taxes as well, do you?
What's the point with taxes, you fucking idiot? That's how they got Al Capone, isn't it?
Well, how do you register that then? What, you say you're illegal fucking drugs and guns and shit like that? What are you on about?
Are you dumb? Do you know what the concept of money laundering means? Have you heard that phrase, money laundering?
Obviously I have, money fucking...
How do you think that works then? How do you think people do that?
What, you try to say that you've got an accountant and says, oh, this is...
I've got two accountants, mate. The way you launder money is you have a legitimate business that you funnel illegal money through.
Yeah, I understand the principle of laundering money. What I'm saying is... Look, fuck what I'm saying. All I'm saying, have you got the fucking thing or what?
Have you got the money?
Yeah, of course I've got the fucking money.
Well, let me see the money and you can see the thing.
Oh, well, That's a bit childish, isn't it? What do you say? You get the gun out and I'll get you the money out. How about that one?
Right, thing is, mate, you are trying to buy an illegal, unregistered, untraceable firearm, okay?
Yes.
So, we are now doing it my way because we are now in my place of business. If you want to go to a gunsmith's, I know a very good gunsmith in Penzance.
All right, forget it. I'll give you his number. Right, here's the fucking money. Here's the money. Right?
Right. Thank you.
What are you saying? If you went to a shop, you wouldn't go, oh, I'll give you the money first. Can I have whatever you're going to buy? I don't know what the fuck you're going to be. But you could be in a hardware store. You could be fucking, I don't know, you could be anywhere, couldn't you?
Do you know what, mate? You're absolutely right, Pardy. If you went into a shop, that is how it would work. This is not a shop. This is my place of business, and therefore I dictate the rules of how that business is carried out. Do you see what I mean? Now, as I say, I know a perfectly good place, mate.
You got, you're well connected. Just fucking count the money in.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
There you go, mate. That's very kind of you. Oh, for fuck.
What?
The fuck is that?
It's a pistol.
Yeah, fucking pistol. Like a flintlock. Is this your granddad's First World War issue or something?
Nothing wrong with First World War armaments, mate. Killed a lot of Germans.
Yeah, fucking killed a lot of Germans. Back in the day, this hasn't seen action since the Somme.
Mate, that firearm is perfectly serviceable, I can guarantee that.
What, you've got a guarantee of your what? If I injure myself, I'll get an insurance claim on it, can I?
The only way you're going to injure yourself is if you do something stupid, like putting in your pocket and accidentally knocking the trigger and setting it off, staring down the barrel looking for something that goes
up in the stare down the barrel of it. Oh, wait a minute, though. Oh, fucking Pete Jewell, didn't he? The actor from, was it Annabelle A's and Keith Curry?
Yeah, he done it, didn't he?
Yeah, well, they say, I think it was fucking suicide. So.
Well, like Brandon Lee, innit? You know, was he playing with the firearm?
No,
was that a suicide attempt?
That wasn't a real firearm, was it?
Well, it was a blank firearm one, exactly. Yeah. Well, that's what I'm saying to you, mate. If Brandon Lee had been playing with that, he wouldn't have been any better off.
What I'm saying with Brandon Lee, I don't think he actually shot himself.
You think the intention wasn't?
No, I think it was, you know, they had the explosive things.
Oh, the squibs, yeah.
That's what they're called, isn't it? Squibs. Right. I think it was one of them.
It was one of them, was it?
I don't know, mate. I wasn't one of them. Anyway, point is, right, I hope this fucking works.
Absolutely works, mate.
I ain't being funny. You'll be fucking careful, yeah?
Why?
You could die of fucking ink poisoning.
Yeah, you're right about that, actually. I can think of worse ways to go, though.
Anyway, well, I'd say it was a pleasure doing business with you, but as it goes, it was just weird.
Well, sorry you feel that way, Parv. Best of luck.
Yeah, you too, buddy.
Fucking Amex.
Hi, Stephen.
Where's your dad?
I don't know. He's out.
Anybody else here?
No, just me.
Clear.
Did he say when he'd be back?
No, he just disappeared.
Yeah, he does that. What's that?
It's Marmite.
You know I don't like Marmite.
Don't you?
No.
Marmite's good for you.
Go and see if they've got any Nutella.
Nutella's really bad for me.
You trying to say I'm fat?
No, I'm just saying. Marmite's good for you.
Nutella.
Hi, this is Mrs. Spickernell again. I'm really concerned about my daughter. Have you got any new information on her? I wouldn't have to keep calling if you just let me stay there. Utterly ridiculous. It's really stressful and you don't know what I've been through. We made a dream.
Okay, fine.
You write it.
Well, I can't write. Mine's all greasy and my handwriting's shit.
Well, they'll never read it if I write it. Yeah, you write your own ransom note.
It was raining. She's come a long way down. Because I was late again. But the umbrella went way out of town.
Stephen! You're fucking kidding!
You're joking, right?
What do you mean?
I thought you'd seen him. You made me stop like that. I could have crashed. And you didn't even get us a flake.
Well, you had chocolate on your toast. Too much chocolate will make you hyper. See what I mean? You're getting hyper already.
I'm a finisher, you little prick.
Oi, what's up, mate? Sit down, just calm down.
What do you mean, what's up?
Mate, I'd have come and met you from Exeter. Why don't you give me a shout?
Well, I'll give you a shout.
Yeah,
What do you mean, why didn't I give you a fucking shout?
I come up, brought some of the boys up, you know, give you a lift home.
What, like when you helped me out the first time when you fucking left me stranded?
Mate, I didn't leave you stranded. Come on, don't think of it like that, Leif.
I served 5 years
mate,
for you.
I know you
five
did,
years.
And I appreciate it.
I didn't say a fucking word.
I know.
And now what?
Yeah, I talked to you about that. You've always been a good soldier, mate, and you'll get rewarded properly.
Rewarded?
Like a soldier does. Yeah,
what?
Yeah, yeah.
What, by getting my little brother involved?
Mate, he was just
my fucking little brother involved!
He was just keeping the seat
What's
warm.
What's wrong
for you,
with
mate?
You, man? What do you mean, keeping the seat warm?
Just, you know, sitting for you, mate. Don't
you
don't worry.
You fucking little prick.
Nathan, please, mate. I'll make everything all right. I'll make it all up to all you,
right.
I swear to God. I've always been good to you and your family, mate, haven't I? Haven't I?
Yeah. Yeah. What? Do you know what? Fucking my mum, fucking aged 20 years since I've been in
She's
the
a
nick.
Good woman, your mother. I wouldn't have a word
good
said
woman.
Against her.
Do you know what? My brother goes in the nick. What then? She been tipped over the edge. And then what?
Mate, we can
What's
sort this. Nathan, we can sort this.
Sort
just put the knife away.
This. Do you know what?
Nathan,
it's too
please.
Fucking late for me.
Nathan.
And the only way my brother's going to be free is if you're fucking
wiped
out,
Nate.
You
don't want to do this! Ah! What the fuck have you done?
Right in hell, you little prick.
That's fantastic. That's brilliant, thank you. I'm going to leave him. I'll tell her. I'm leaving immediately. And also, could you just tell her I love her? Thank you. Thanks. Bye.
Invisible man returns. You took your time.
Where's my son, Jack?
First things first, you little prick.
Well, it's now to get personal. Leave my prick out of it, eh?
Oh, you think you're a funny man, do you? I'll show you something funny.
Well, you've got a bit of a warped sense of humour if you think that's funny, buddy. Yeah, anyone ever told you that?
Well, yeah, actually. My psychotherapist told me that inside.
Yeah, and what did he prescribe?
He prescribed nothing, because I punched him in the face! Oh my God!
What the fuck have you done?
I think I broke my finger or something. Oh.
How'd you do that?
I was trying a new technique.
A new technique? I've shown you how to punch.
Yeah, but I watched this documentary on Charlene Monks.
A documentary?
Yeah, on the Discovery Channel.
You've got the Discovery Channel?
Well, no, it's not mine. It's my mum's, but I watched it. And this little fucking prick, he's broke my hand. I tell you what, I'm going to kick you right in the bollocks.
What the fuck is that?
Don't worry about what the fuck this is, yeah? Take another step forward, you're gonna get a good old-fashioned shot to the bollocks. A little technique I learned on Movies for Men. Now, as I said before, where's my fucking son, Jack?
Enough of this bollocks. You know what we want. We do a nice little exchange, we all go home with our bollocks intact.
What the fuck?!
Hello, Mum? Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm fine. Oh, listen. Now, listen. I tell Jason I've sorted it. I'll explain later. Alright. Alright, bye. Bye.
Oh,
okay. Stay calm. Just stay calm. Let me untie you. Look, I've got something to tell you. Your dad thinks... Now, this is your dad. Your dad thinks it's better if he's not involved in your life anymore.
What?
Get up, get up. I'll explain, I'll explain.
What is left of you? Your oldest fear is that you might see your soul. And down to the sea you run, the edge of life, no soul left.
Usual?
Yeah, not bad, mate. Yeah, usual, please, yeah.
Oi, right, Fred.
Yeah? Hold on. How's business? How's your old work?
Yeah, not too bad, yeah.
Oh,
good
ideal,
morning.
Yeah.
How's the old holiday then?
Yeah, I can't complain, yeah. A lot, you know, yeah, a lot of holiday makers this time of year, so I'm doing alright, you know.
Did you hear about old Fred?
God, no, I did, yeah.
No, dreadful business, wasn't it? Awful.
Just like sunlight splits the dark, just like lovers leave their mark, just like raindrops fill the pail, just like warm winds fill the sail, just like anyone I ever loved that's gone, just like singing you my message in a song, just like never knowing where you belong, goes on and on. Just like rainbows crown the rain, just like heartbreak tops the pain, just like secrets left untold, just like having someone to hold, just like everyone I ever loved is gone, just like singing you my message in a song, just like never knowing where you belong. Haunt the day, just like friends.